I am delighted to have been asked to send this audio postcard to the Australian Law Reform Commission on the occasion of its 40th anniversary. I was a commissioner in the lead up to the 30th anniversary. I had a 3-year term commencing at the end of 2001 and worked on 3 inquiries: civil penalties, gene patenting and human health, and phase 1 of the review of the Uniform Evidence Act. I have to say that the ALRC was, and I imagine still is, a wonderful place to work. Under President David Weisbrot, it was collegial, professional, and had an abiding commitment to thorough and principled law reform. I've been asked to comment on what I remember as the most significant contribution made to law reform made by the ALRC during my time there. By the time I was there, the process of law reform was well established, with its major emphasis on consultation and the testing of proposals in an iterative process. My time at the ALRC coincided with 2 large inquiries that dealt with issues in the forefront of science: the protection of human genetic information and gene patenting and human health. Of course, it was not the first time the ALRC had looked at matters dealing with science, health and law, and the Human Tissue Transplant Report published in 1977 remains a landmark. What was interesting about the combination of the 2 genetic inquiries was the breadth of issues addressed in what was, and still is, a fast-developing area. The gene patenting inquiry coincided with the announcement of the completion of the sequencing of the human genome, and throughout the ALRC we were taking guesses at the number of human genes that would be identified. My recollection is that none of us guessed it would be quite so low. The Protection of Genetic Information report attracted a large amount of interest and well-deserved praise, and so much of what it said was prescient and holds good today. Gene patenting and human health, the reference I worked on, was perhaps more controversial, and indeed is still being played out in the High Court. What it showed was the enormous complexity that comes with balancing competing claims, all of which have some merit, even within the various branches of government. Among scientists and health professionals, there were different views. It was an inquiry that threw up very difficult and complex policy considerations. I certainly learned how hard public policy can be. On a completely different vein, I was there during the genesis of the project to mark 30 years of the ALRC. I have to say it was an inspired suggestion by Commissioner Brian Apeskin that the ALRC produce an edited book that explored the history and process of law reform. Brian and David Weisbrot put together a rich collection of scholarship that is still a valuable resource a decade later. I've also been asked to comment on what I think are the key challenges for law reform in the next decade. It's probably crass or trite if I say money, but budgets are a reflection of the value placed on law reform by government, and in a highly contested budgetary environment, there's a risk of death by 1,000 cuts. Law reform takes time and hence money, and anything that severely truncates the process may diminish the value of the reports. Yet law reform bodies themselves need to ensure they remain adaptable and able to respond quickly to changing circumstances in a world where global as well as domestic forces are well at play. And I guess the other challenge is the perennial one of how to ensure governments take notice once an inquiry has been completed. Let me finish on a bright note by saying again, congratulations to the ALRC on its first 40 years, and best wishes for many, many more.